I'm Fraser Cain, the publisher of Universe Today. As long as humans survive, we will be increasing our energy consumption. We want better transportation, faster computers, and stuff we just can't even imagine yet. It's going to take energy, and lots of it. If you plot our overall use since the industrial era, you can see that it's just a line that goes up and up. There will come a time in the future when we've exhausted all the fossil and nuclear fuels. And once we've harvested as much wind, solar, and geothermal energy as our planet can produce, we're going to need to move out into space and collect energy directly from the sun. We will construct larger and larger solar arrays, beaming the energy back to Earth. Inevitably, we'll enclose the entire sun in a cloud of solar satellites, allowing us to make use of 100% of the radiation it's emitting. This is a Dyson Sphere. The concept was first developed as part of a research paper in 1960 by the physicist Freeman Dyson. In a thought experiment, he assumed that the power needs for civilizations never stops increasing. If our descendants could actually figure out how to enclose our star in a rigid shell, we'd have 550 million times more surface area than Earth has right now and generate 384 yottawatts of energy. Sounds great. Lots of living space and free energy. But there are a host of problems. There wouldn't be any gravity to keep anything stuck to the surface of the sphere. It would all drop down towards the star and be destroyed. The sphere would be free-floating in space, and unless you could keep it balanced in relation to the star, it would eventually collide with it. Finally, there might not be enough material to build a shell. This advanced civilization would need to make use of all our planets, asteroids, and comets. In fact, even if you dismantled everything in the solar system, you'd probably only have enough to build a shell about 15 centimeters thick. The physical strength of this material would have to be immense. Otherwise, the sphere itself would just implode and collapse into the star. Dyson himself freely admitted that the idea of a rigid shell surrounding a star is unfeasible. Instead, he and others have proposed that civilizations would probably build a dense swarm of objects on independent orbits around the star, a Dyson cloud, or maybe a Dyson ring. Each solar satellite would be stable on its own and capable of beaming its energy back to some planet. You could also build a cloud of solar sails. These objects would be held in perfect balance between the gravity pulling them inward and the light pressure from the sun pushing them outward. They wouldn't need to orbit at all to maintain a static distance from the sun. A full Dyson sphere is probably impossible. But if we assume that alien civilizations' energy needs will continue to grow like ours, it makes sense to search the galaxy for megastructures just in case. Even though the shell would absorb the light and high energy radiation from the star, it would still emit infrared radiation, which would be detectable in our telescopes. Even a partial Dyson cloud would give off a telltale light signature as it obscured the light from a star. This gives us yet another way we could search for extraterrestrial civilizations. And if we did find a full Dyson sphere out there in the Milky Way, well, let's just hope they're nice aliens. Thanks for watching. Thanks for watching. Now make sure you click subscribe on our YouTube channel over here. And maybe you've still got some questions about space and astronomy, like this one or that one. And if you don't see the question you're looking for, then send me an email at info@universetoday.com.